Welcome to School of Civil Engineering. In this video, I'll discuss about ETAP's tutorial, and as I have started a video about ETAP's tutorial, this is the lecture 3. And in this lecture, I will discuss about analysis of beam. Previous video we have discussed about beam on point load. Now we'll discuss about a beam with a point load and also distributed load. So let's start, and next video we'll discuss about a beam with a point load, distributed load and also varying load, uniformly varying load. So let's start, and before that see my intro. Suppose that this is the beam, and we'll solve that beam. There have 70, 40, 70, 40, 40, 60 meter. We'll consider that in meter. They have 1 kilonewton point load, 5 kilonewton uniformly distributed load, 4 kilonewton point load and 2 kilonewton point load. And also they have two portion of cantilever portion and one middle portion. So let's start and check the value. Is it okay or not with ETAPS? So let's start. First of all, we'll open our ETAPS, then go to new model. You if you don't know how to use that, see my previous video. I think it will be clear to you. And today in this video, I'll use built-in setting width. So I use built-in setting, and here I'll use matrix SI unit, and it will be default because it's not so important in to analyze a simple beam. So okay, now we'll select our grid system. In previous video I have told you that first of all we'll select blank and then we'll edit, but in this video we'll edit from here. So first of all, as we are using a simple beam, so our estuary height will be 2 or 1. Estuary height will be 1. Our topical estuary height will be 3 meter. It's not mandatory. And here this is the main thing, uniformly grid spacing. Here is the main thing. So first of all, we have to see that how much grid we'll consider. We'll consider about one grid here, one grid in B, two grid in F, grid 3, and in Z, grid 4. So we'll consider four grid in X direction, and S is the only one, a single line, so there have no grid in Y direction. I mean in X direction we'll consider 4, and in Y direction we'll consider 1. And here spacing 8 8, so we have to change that. To change that, we have to go custom grid spacing grid, and here we'll change our grid. First of all, we have to select display grid data as spacing here, and what is our total distance. First of all 70, and here 40 70 40 40. So first of all, first spacing 70, then 40 plus 3 into 40, 1, 2, 0, plus 7, 0. Then let's check again, 40, 40, 40, 120, and 70, 190, and last is 60. Last is here 60, 60, and it will be 0. why I have told you previous in my previous video, because if we provide 17 in A, it means the distance between A to V. If we provide a distance in V, it means distance between B to C. And your Y grid, they have no spacing, it's only one grid but no spacing. Okay, we can also use here our bubble size will not work anymore here, so click OK, grid only, OK. Here we're seeing that, let's delete that. Here we're seeing that this our grid 1, grid 2, grid 3 and grid 4. Let's it's not visible to us clearly, so for that let's again edit our grid, and they have on history base and on history. Let's add on other history. Okay, add from here you can add another windows, add new windows here, our new windows, and it's we'll see it in 3D. So the main reason is, let's again cut it here, the main reason is it's showing very, if I zoom it, it's showing very small because the distance is very far, distance is more, that's why it's showing like that, because you can see from here the 70 meter, 40 meter, 70 meter, 40 meter, 40 meter, 60 meter. So let's go, and now we'll draw, first of all we'll draw a beam. So to draw beam, go to here, no need to do anything, just come here and draw beam. It's 70 meter. Then on next grid it's 90 meter as we see in before, and it's 60 meter. And after click here, then right click, it's done. Now it's being very difficult to see chords because its length is very high and height is very low. So click here for selected tools. Let's modify it again. Edit a screw height and modify from here a screw height. Then let's 15 meter, S3 1 and S2 2 also 15 meter. But if we use that, our grid will show in high. So from here, let's see. From here we can see elevation view apply. So here our line, so from B, from here to here our beam, it's now it's clear. So we have draw our beam, then go for support, here a support B and here also a support F. So as they have not defined as which RC roller or who is our pin, so we'll take anything here. So first of all click here, assign joint restraint, and select here as a pin, sorry, a heel support, and click here, select here and again go assign, join, restrained. Now again select here and assign, join, restraint, and as we have provided here hinge support, then we'll provide a roller support. Here is the roller, apply. Okay, done. And our beam and support are done. Then we have to provide load. So for point load, simply we'll click on that beam and go for assign frame load point load. Here we'll use dead load, add to existing load, dead load, then force gravity as we are putting the load in the gravity direction, and distance we'll use absolute distance from int, and y we'll select that. I have already discussed it on below. So from here in distance 0 we'll use load 1 kilonewton, then apply. Here I have provided 1 kilonewton load, and then we have to provide load at here we have a load uniform distributed load from distance 17 to from here. So how will provide that load? So let's see. First of all, we have to select that beam portion. Okay, that portion. So go assign frame load, but this time we have to select distributed load, and here in distributed load force gravity load, and here we have to select absolute distance and first of all we have to see that at 40 distance later the load have started, and in a 40 plus 70 110 meter distance it have finished 5 kilonewton. So from here at 40 the load is 5, and at 1 on 0 the load is 5. Apply. Okay, here load have applied it. Again we have to select that, cause now we'll provide our point load. The point load is from 4487, it's 150 meter distance point load. So how will provide that? Select that beam, assign frame load point load, and we have to click here add to existing load, and here force gravity dead load absolute, and in distance 150 meter our load is almost 4 kilonewton. Apply. Okay, so 154, and again we have to provide another load here 2 kilonewton in third grid. So here select that, now again select that portion of beam and assign frame. frame lot, point lot, and how much distance in the two kilonewton lot in 60 meter distance. Distance is 60 meter and the load is 20 kg. Okay. Then we have to click here for analysis and have to save the file. Save your file. Beam. Save and analyze. So this is the deform shape of this beam. Now we'll check reaction. And here we'll check now shear show value. Here we're showing that shear diagram for the beam, and again go for moment diagram, apply. Here is the moment diagram, but here value are showing 2459, but here this value is very low. So what is the difference is here? So here difference is that this analyze taking the self weight of that beam, self weight of that beam. So for that we'll unlock it, select both beam, and we'll go assign frame modify property modifier. From property modifier we'll provide head 0 and also provide head 0. So when we'll provide head 0 0, the beam will not consider or analysis not consider is self weight. Apply. Okay, again analyze. So this is the its original deform shape. From here see its shear. Apply. Its shear diagram here, apply. This is its moment diagram. Click here, it's showing its moment M3 value here. 70. So in this way we can solve that beam. So if you think that you have a problem about one, you can comment me below or you can contact me. I will try to solve that. Thank you very much. Stay well, stay connected.